Welcome to Longjiang Gymnasium, where the judo is about to begin the evening session where medals will be decided. Very exciting couple of hours ahead here as the gold, bronze, I should say gold, silver and two bronze medals will be awarded in three weight divisions. The women's 52 kilograms division, the men's 81 kilogram division, and also in addition we have the third category being decided tonight, the under 63 kilogram division for the women's. So the big matches are ahead. It's been a wonderful day of competition, and the most important matches lie in the next hour and a half or so here at the Longjiang Stadium in Nanjing. The Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games in full swing. It's been some very, very tight competition through the day in these weight divisions, but now the medalists await their chance at the glory. Checking on phones, taking photos. Lots of excitement around the stadium as everyone's awaiting the appearance of the first judokas who will be contesting for the bronze medal in the 52 kilogram and under division. Contestants, coaches, spectators, team members, everyone's here in the stadium. And broadcasters. So each weight division will first have the contest for the bronze medals, and that will be followed by the gold medal match. And we are about to see the appearance of the first of the under 52 kilogram division contest for bronze medal, and it will be Liu Zhaoyu of China against Marusa Stanga of Slovenia. That will be followed by the men's under 81 kilogram division contests as well. We'll have medal ceremonies, of course.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, now we begin the World Gold Medal Contest for women under 52 kilograms.
新年朋友们，女士们、先生们，女子柔道52公斤第一场铜牌决赛现在开始。
Please welcome the referees.
Here come the athletes, the referees are being introduced as well. The officials have such an important role to play. Eighteen judogas were entered in the women's under 52 kilogram division, and we are down now to the final six for the medals. From China in the white, Liu Zhaoyu. And in the blue, from Slovenia, Marusa Stanga. The bronze medal contest begins, the first of the bronze medals to be decided. Stanga is just 16 years old. Liu is 18, so she has a little more experience on board than her younger opponent. But it's the lady in blue, Marusa Stanga, who has the upper hand early and goes into a hold immediately here. Referee chasing them around the circle as they rotate on the ground. The hold, is it in place? Will we see a submission here? As trying to escape the hold, but the referee will call them back to the center on their feet. But we've got a problem here for Liu Zhaoyu, in a lot of pain there with the arm being controlled. Now the officials have been called in here to have a look at a video replay and just ascertain whether or not they feel that there should have been a score awarded here. They have different views to look at on replay. The referee made no call as such during the contest, which is of course only 40 seconds old, not even. And it is, it's called Ippon. So a hold was applied, and while the clock didn't start on the hold, the officials have decided that it was a winning hold, a winning score, winner by Ippon in very quick time. And it's Maruša Stanga who wins the bronze medal for Slovenia. Winner by Ippon. Well, we didn't see much of a contest. It was all over so quickly. An emphatic move by the younger of the two opponents. You might be able to see from this angle the lock there. Look at the strain of Stanga as she applied the lock and held on tight. The second bronze medal contest is ready to begin, and this features Lee of Korea against Yanashvili of Georgia. So in the white, Lee Hayakyong of the Republic of Korea, in the white, as I say, and in blue it's Mariam Yanashvili of Georgia. And the Korean on the attack here early, no score registered. Lee going into the throw and then putting her opponent down, and some problems here for Yanashvili, who limps back to her position. She nods her head to say I'm okay. Now she bounces, but she's protecting her right leg, and she's on her back here. Forceful drive, the leg hood put in place, and the referee steps in and declares Ippon in favor of Lee Hayakyong of Korea. Yanashvili, who injured her leg in the first execution of technique, struggles back to her feet. She is in real pain, and she will hobble away, disappointed to have missed out on a bronze medal. She goes through the formalities of taking her position and bowing, but she is in a bad way. But a great moment for Lee Hayakyong, who in very quick time, like Maruša Stanga, has wrapped up a bronze medal, in this case for Korea. She knew to attack. It was like a wounded animal. The hunter went for the kill, placed the leg, and then drove over the top. And on the back foot there, Yanashvili could not resist the attack with an injured right leg. The gold medal contest for the under 52 kilogram women. And Liana Coleman of Brazil will meet Bettina Tamulkova of Bulgaria. Liana Coleman of Brazil in the white. Bettina Tamulkova of Bulgaria in the blue. Tamulkova is just 17 years old, competing at the Youth Olympic Games here in Nanjing. And underway, both guaranteed of at least a silver medal, but when you get to this stage of competition, it's a gold medal that every bit of your being wants. Heart, soul, mind, everything wants that gold medal. And no one will be satisfied with silver. Both 17 years old, so they've met competition during the day of quite a few 18-year-olds and been able to overcome them. and the Brazilian showing strength now. Coleman on top and could be going for the strangle here. They've out of the contest area, but it was initiated just inside. And the referee will bring them back to the center. The gold medal at stake. Fighting for the grip. Coleman aggressive, comes over the top, can't get the grip, but she counter-attacks now. And turns her opponent over. Temakova tries to resist with the bridge. And Temakova, oh, it's called Ippon. It is Ippon. The Bulgarian in trouble. And Coleman wins the gold medal. Liana Coleman wins the contest for the gold medal in a minute and 20 seconds. Ippon scored. Liana Coleman signaled by the scoreboard as the winner and now by the referee. And the Bulgarian limping away. Bettina Temelkova beaten, but look at the celebrations now for Liana Coleman. She runs to her coach and celebrates a mighty, wonderful day's work, winning the gold medal. And this shows the injury for Temelkova. She reaches down and holds her leg. Beaten by Coleman, by Ippon. And the gold medal decided in favour of Liana Coleman. See there, at that point, Temelkova resisting, trying to bridge up. As Coleman went on the attack and then got the arm lock in place. And finally submitted. Submitted, so the leg injury was just collateral damage.